their hard work that they have put in the last 2 years, we will be looking forward to their cooperation and to the cooperation of all of them.
I would like now to draw your attention to the provisional agenda and program of the work for this session, which is contained in document A/AC/198/2023/1.
A letter was also received as well on 30th March from the permanent mission of El Salvador as part of the group of Latin American Caribbean Roman Commissions. And finally, a letter was received from the chair of the Western European and Other States Group on 31st March, informing about the endorsed nomination of Ms. Lovrika Orazami from Italy. That makes Ms. Vera Francoa Andrea Mendoza, Ms. Liliana Veronica Barbosa, and Ms. Lovrika Orazami, the post of vice chairs and family relations.
Over the coming days, we will be discussing a wide range of issues, the role of the media in shaping public opinion, the importance of bridging the digital divide, the need to combat disinformation, hate speech, and on how to confront the harmful or misleading content. First, we must ensure the integrity of information. In today's fast-paced, interconnected world, the spread of disinformation is causing discontent and destabilizing societies. We will also be exploring ways to promote access to information for all, including marginalized communities, including migrants, refugees, IDPs, and those who are living in affected areas affected by conflict and national disaster.
Fourth, we must confirm the existential threat of climate change. Catastrophic threat in Pakistan last year, the terrible earthquake hit in Turkey and Syria this year, and the threat posed by rising sea water